Hi viewers, you're welcome to my YouTube channel. This is your girl Marfel. Wow, if you are just joining me today for your very first time, please you want to consider hitting the subscription button below. Why not turn on the notification bell so that whenever I release a very interesting video like this one, you are going to be notified. And please watch this video till the end. From the topic, you have seen that it's a very sensitive topic, and it's something that 3 out of every 10 women they suffer a lot from: vagina itches, vagina smell, and vagina discharges. So today we are going to be looking at why do we have reoccurrence in these bacteria and fungi infections. Okay, so today I will not really be talking much on the causes, but I'll be talking more on why do we think that these infections reoccur and reoccur again. So we are going to be looking at possible home remedies in order to treat vagina itches, vagina smell, and vagina discharges, especially those colorful discharges. So what is vagina itches? I want to say that vagina itches is not a medical condition, but it is a sign and symptoms to so many medical conditions. We have so many sexually transmittable diseases like gonorrhea, syphilis, and we have others that when this bacteria enters into the body of a woman, it could show sign by vagina itching. It could show sign with you having a very offensive vagina smear and colorful vagina discharges. And this thing, I don't think you would be comfortable with it. So today we are going to be looking at 3 or 4 home remedies that you would use as a woman at home in order to prevent yourself not from having vagina itches or not from having reoccurrence of this particular illness. So one of the first things I'm going to talk about is cyst bud. One of the home remedies in which you want to keep your vagina very clean, very odorless, not from itching and offensive smell, one of the things you consider doing is cyst bud. What is cyst bud? Cyst bud is a procedure whereby you could boil hot water, warm water, okay? Yeah, you could pour it on a pail. Then you could consider putting a handful of salt into the water. You want to sit on it in order to trap the vapor, okay? Please don't wear pants when you're doing this, okay? Please sit on it directly like that. It's very painful because the hot vapor from you will be hitting the vagina and you feel a lot of pain. But please consider sitting for at least 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, if you cannot bear the pain, you could get up and rest for a while, but make sure you do it for at least 3 times 10 minutes. And this hobby should be done at least twice a month. It should not, don't do it on a daily basis. You can just do it twice a month. And secondly, I want to talk about garlic. Garlic is very good when it comes to curing us from vagina itches, offensive smell, and colorful discharges. Take a garlic, a size of a garlic that you feel comfortable sending it through your vagina. What happens is that it will reduce or it will kill the bacteria that is causing the vagina itches, because garlic is high. Garlic is a very good source of antibiotics, okay? So when you peel that particular garlic clove that you are comfortable with, you will consider using a needle. Please, this needle should be clean, it should be sterile. What do I mean it should be clean and sterile? You want to boil hot water. Please drop this needle into that hot water, okay, with a thread. So what happens is that when you pass this thread through the needle, you will want to consider putting some marks on the garlic and then piercing it all through, allowing the rope, and then knot it at the other end, so that when you send it to your vagina, especially in the night, you want to sleep over and then remove it in the morning. The rope on it will help you to pull it out. And the third thing I want us to talk about is using aloe vera gel. Aloe vera gel, when I talk of aloe vera gel, I'm talking about live aloe vera, okay? You want to consider scraping the juice out of the aloe vera, okay? Because it is very slippery, it will be difficult for you to insert it into your vagina. So what happens is that when you get this aloe vera gel, you will tie, that is, you look for a very clean plastic paper, you will tie some portion of it, put it into the refrigerator. I mean, that quantity in which you can easily send it into your vagina without having any problem. And this particular method is good for you to do it in the night. And when you want to do it, please pad yourself, because as the ice is dissolving, that's how the water will be coming out of your vagina. That is another method in which you will keep your vagina clean. In fact, it will not have any smell, and you'll be comfortable with your partner around you. Then the last thing I want to talk about is perineal wash. How do you take care of your perineal area? Your perineal area consists of your vagina, it consists of the perineum, and it consists of the anus. When you visit the toilet, how do you clean? Do you clean from front to back, or you clean from back to front? I want to advise you that please, if you have that habit of cleaning from back to front, please stop it, because it will always affect you, and by this you will always have vagina itches, because you will introduce bacteria from the anus to your vagina. So clean from front to back, and please make sure that you don't douche all the time. Douching all the time makes you to kill the normal flora of your vagina, thereby exposing your vagina to bacteria. So my people, this is just what I put for this edition. Please continue to watch, like, subscribe, and share. There is a woman somewhere that needs this information in order to be saved. Thank you, stay blessed, and God bless you.